Life is sometimes a roller coaster. For some people, it's a struggle. For this semester in general, I've learned a lot of different things about photography, about account planning, which, frankly, I don't think I am. I'm really a planning person. And art history, which is always good to know. But this semester in general has taught me a lot of things. And part of the homework assignment was to do some books about the subject. The first book is Ian Fleming's James Bond series, Live and Let Die. Ian Fleming is a wonderful writer, and here's an excerpt from the part of his book. Stay alive, it says. You must stay alive to the last possible second. They must keep breathing while they are hauled, a living bundle through the sea. Much depended on how they be bound together. Mr. Big wanted them to stay alive. He would not be interested in dead bait. If they were still alive when the shark fin showed the surface behind them, Bond coldly decided to drown Solitaire. Then he would try to drown himself. Now, this is an action adventure story. Specifically, it's known for high action thrill rides, but the reader has to imagine it opposed to the films. Another action story, more of a Romeo and Juliet, is the Koga Ninja Scrolls, translated by Ferto Adimata. Well, written by Ferto Adimata, little expert from Ninja Scrolls. The Iga men realized why the Kamigachi Shugogan had made the final groan and why he pointed his dying strength in the Harling Scroll. That thing, Ushimajigan, how it could crawl without any arms or legs. It was here. What happened to that chicken Nitsun? But in their confusion to see the thing that escaped with the scroll, they forgot to question and chase after it. Haramatu, left behind, carried the mountain sword as she approached Kazuya and Shogun. The three pursuing Iga men could not believe her inability to catch the thing. Although the three were far swifter than any normal humans, they could not gain any ground on the villainous ninja. The pursuit of the other world creature continued over 4 miles, separating the stations with Shonen and Kirimaga. Three of the three Iga ninja could see through the dark that they were losing sight of the slithering enemy in the weakening moonlight. They painted their spare UGH! A distance in the far front of them. There was a sound of extraordinary groan. While all three could not see it, the shadow suddenly appeared before Jingan Shibaki. The groan came from Shibaki Shun along the sea of what he saw. Shibaki spit out the scroll. You got in your mouth, Shadow said. There was a gentle tinkle with laughter. If you don't spit out the scroll, you won't be able to find your spear. While still holding the scroll in his mouth, Jubeki's eyes bulged. The enemy was correct. His only weapon was blocked. He had to block it himself, but he spun out the scroll, warning that it was about to shoot a spear. I already knew a secret. Behind him, the three Iga rushed closer and closer. But my main point was, both of these books are about action, adventure, and things that I'd like to fantasize about, but not really live. I wouldn't want to be James Bond and being shot at, nor would I want to really be a ninja and, you know, fight with swords and be very worrisome about another clown attacking me. I think if I've learned anything this semester, it's learn who your real allies are, and even if you screw up, they'll still even respect you, and even if you screw up on their lives or their projects and you don't really mean to, well, that's just part of the process. And if you do good work in the process, well, good job for you. If not, oh well. That's all I got to say. Peace out, Girl Scouts.